Hi, this is Ms. Carden, your chemistry teacher. I set up a simple experiment. I have two balloons. One is filled completely with air, and the other one is almost full with air, but it has a little bit of water at the bottom. I'm going to take two matches and hold one match under each one of these balloons. Write down what you think will happen when I hold a match under each of these balloons, and write down why. Pause the video now and write down your hypothesis. Okay, this is balloon number one with fire.
That is so scary. Okay. Balloon number two.
Balloon number two.
Please don't pop. Okay.
It's almost touching. It's almost touching this balloon. See, the match is practically almost burned out. So, the balloon with water at the bottom didn't pop. Let's go into my classroom and we'll talk about why this happened. Imagine this. You walk to the pool in your neighborhood and you accidentally touch the roof of a car and that car's been sitting there all day. What happens? You burn your hand, right? Well, you go jump in the pool to cool off. You jump in the water and the water feels cool. Both of those things have been sitting there all day. So what's the difference between them? They have different specific heat or heat capacity. And specific heat is defined as the amount of energy required to raise one unit of a substance 1 degree Celsius or Kelvin. I know that sounds like gibberish to you, so let's break it down. The amount of energy, what kind of energy? Thermal energy or heat. Required to raise one unit, usually grams, of a substance, and we're talking about either water or steel, 1 degree Celsius or Kelvin. And just to give you an idea of what a gram looks like, this paperclip is about 1 gram. Notice I didn't say that it weighs 1 gram. Mass and weight are different. Your mass is going to be the same no matter where you are. If you're on the moon, you'll still have the same mass. But if you stand on a scale and weigh yourself on the moon, you're going to weigh a lot less because weight is a force due to gravity. So, also notice that it can either be Celsius or Kelvin. Well, these are basically the same amount, but they're different. They're a different scale. There is no negative degree in Kelvin. It starts at absolute zero, and that's the lowest temperature anything could ever possibly be, and it's pretty much impossible to get there. But no negative degrees in Kelvin. So the units for specific heat can be joules per gram Kelvin or joules per gram Celsius, like we said, is what the typical unit is. So that means heat per gram times temperature, mass times temperature. Notice this J is a joule, and that is how scientists measure heat in joules. The heat capacity for steel is, or specific heat of steel, is 0.49. The heat capacity, or specific heat of water, is 4.187 joules per gram Kelvin. That's 8.5 times higher than steel. So that means that water can absorb 8.5 times more heat than steel and not change its degree. And it has the capacity to do that because of the way that water molecules interact with each other. This is 5 grams of water. Water is typically measured in science in milliliters or liters, but note that grams and milliliters are equal because the density of water is 1 gram per milliliter. So this is 5 grams, but it's also 5 milliliters. If you have any questions, please post them to the Raise Your Hand section in Unit 1.
Okay, this is going to be like the credits. Oh my gosh. Look, do you see the black on it?
Uh-huh.
Do you see the black underneath it? Oh my God.